end of the week. Thank you so much for watching us here on CN2 Now. I'm Lucas McFadden. First up tonight, a 40-year-old woman was killed here in Rock Hill, and the man who police say shot her, he will not be charged. Authorities say 40-year-old Samarian Lindsay was shot by a man who is not yet named, but officers say, again, he will not be charged due to acting in self-defense. Now, the two worked together at a nearby business. Rocco police officers say the shooting happened at Riverwalk Parkway near Sail River Road. Investigators say Lindsay got into a vehicle with her girlfriend, Brittany Reed, and they then blocked the man's vehicle while he was in traffic. The police report says Lindsay walked up to the car and pulled out a gun. The man then pulled his gun out and shot her three times in the chest. Lindsay passed away at the hospital. Reed was charged with assault and battery for punching the man in the face after the shots were fired. After initially being charged with assault and battery, she was then charged with murder. Detectives say due to her being the one who gave the gun to Lindsay. A Lancashire motorcycle crash has claimed the life of a Chester man. Very little information has been released. However, here's what we do know. On Saturday, June the 15th, shortly after 11:30 in the evening, a vehicle collision occurred in the 900 block of North Main Street. The coroner says the driver of the motorcycle has been identified as 31-year-old Forrest Woodard Jr. of Chester. A former assistant county manager with York County is now leading the way for another county in the state. Mike Moore recently was named the county administrator for Beaufort County here in South Carolina. He will officially start on July 1st. Moore, who started with York County in the fall of 2020, is a 27-year Navy veteran. Within York County, he assisted with capital improvement projects, master plans, and operational oversight. Moore was chosen for his new position out of 72 candidates that applied. His starting salary will be $248,000. The position that Moore previously held in York County is now officially open on the website. The York Disabilities Foundation is partnering with the Bounce Out the Stigma project for a basketball camp. It took place this week at the Winthrop Coliseum. The camp is staffed by Max Abilities of York County, the team members there with help from the Winthrop basketball programs. The goal of Bounce Out the Stigma project is to inspire and educate young people with special needs through programs that promote healthy lifestyle choices. Our cameras were there for the final day of camp. It was the award ceremony, a time to honor and celebrate these young athletes. The York Disabilities Foundation provides funding to keep costs low for families who sign up to participate in any of the camps provided by Max Abilities. Piedmont Medical Center's Healthy Over Hungry cereal drive has wrapped up and cameras were rolling as those donations were dropped off at Pilgrim's Inn. The cereal drive kicked off on June the 3rd and finished on June 14th. During that time, residents dropped off boxes of cereal to various Piedmont medical offices. In the end, the community donated more than 18,000 pounds of cereal, which equals 20,000 servings. The cereal is now at Pilgrim's Inn, which was founded in 1981 to help fight against homelessness and hunger in Rock Hill. Here is reaction from the executive director as those cereal boxes were dropped off.
Oh, it means a lot to Pilgrim's Inn and to the community. It means that we're able to ensure that families, especially children, have breakfast throughout the summer and as well as throughout the school year. The food that we get today, the cereal that we get today, will take us through January. And then in January, we'll do an actual fundraiser with the community. They will bring in more cereal that will take us through next June. And then next June, we'll have another annual cereal drive with Piedmont Medical EMS. We can't say too much. We can't say enough about the generosity of Piedmont Medical EMS as well as the community for always thinking about those in need and thinking about Pilgrim's Inn.
Studies show 1 in 6 children struggle with hunger, and the cereal drive is a way to help families have a healthy option for breakfast during the summer months when children are home from school and the need for food increases.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
kidney disease is becoming more and more prevalent, especially with diabetes and hypertension. My training with kidney disease helps me to talk to patients and guide them through the steps that they can take, the changes that they can make into their lifestyles. And we have a dedicated team of providers, including dietitians and pharmacists that we work with to educate patients towards achieving that.
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
Being there for someone in their time of need is what Green Funeral Home has done compassionately for four generations. It's a privilege we take very seriously.
We believe each life should be honored and remembered by family and friends. Whether you choose traditional burial in our chapel or another venue, or cremation provided by our on-site crematory, we will help guide you through each step to ensure your needs are met.
We are also available to discuss pre-planning, peace of mind that you have helped your loved one by making those difficult decisions.
When the need arises, our family is here for your family.
This is CN2 Now. A company that was founded out of Princeton University in 2019 is coming to Chester County. Princeton New Energy recycles lithium batteries from electric vehicles, consumer electronics, and other devices. Here is the Chester County Administrator, Brian Hester, with more details of this economic deal.
You've had a big day there in Chester County. You brought all the top brass from Columbia to Chester for a major economic development announcement, and we'll let you take it from there.
Well, thank you, Lucas and Ashley. And yes, we did. We had a big day yesterday in Chester. It was really our first announcement of industry coming to Chester this fiscal year, which is hard to believe, kind of. And it doesn't seem like we're already in June, but, last year we had $1.97 billion in investment in Chester. And so we've had a lot of activity, economic development activity, but this is the first real industry to close thus far this year. And this one is really interesting. Princeton New Energy, and they are one of a kind process and industry in our nation. And they are going to recycle the lithium ion batteries, and they're going to do it from, when I say recycle, they're going to do it all parts of the recycling. And so there's different parts. I am not a scientist. I have listened to these talks, and I've been to the really cool thing is I went out to McKinney, Texas, and visited their pilot plant, or what, you know, where they were putting this process together. They're out of New Jersey, but they had a plant in McKinney, Texas, very small plant, and took a look at their process to really understand it. But basically what they do is recycle every piece of that battery just about. And for something that we in our country right now do not have a process for, we rely on other countries to do what they're doing. Not only are they going to do the process here in our country, and it'll be the first, it's very clean. It's what they call green tech. And so it is very clean, it's very safe, and it basically keeps 70% more of that material out of our landfill. And it reduces the cost of the process or the cost of the materials that they recycle to 40% for companies that are using the recycled material. So it's really neat, and I can't really explain it all, but I will tell you this. When I went out and looked at the facility they had in Texas, I was really what amazed me the most is I saw the evolution of their process. The reason we went there is because we were concerned, you know, we want the right type of businesses in Chester. We want safe businesses. When you start talking about lithium batteries, recycling, the dangers, the fire hazards, and the things that can come with when you start to accumulate items like that, and it's not really easy to put fires out with those. But when we looked at their process from a safety standpoint, they exceed anything that we could have imagined and what they told us. So that on that front, we were very satisfied. The other thing was the process itself. I was amazed at the owners, the scientists. These guys are all way smarter people than I am. And they created this process from scratch. created a machinery, and you see the evolution of their machines. You know, here's how it started. Here's the next set of refining of that process, and then the final where they were. And it's really unique to see how they take all those different parts out of those batteries. They call it, you know, the black mass, the lithium ion, the cathodes, and they recycle every ounce of that and get it back into use. So it was really neat. It's a small project. When you talk about projects of kind of scale, it's $11 million investment initially with 41 jobs, but the jobs all pay above 15% above what the average national average pay is, which is really good. The second part is they've applied for a Department of Energy grant. If they get this Department of Energy grant, which we will know in August, then they will expand to a $250 million investment. And that they'll have two phases of this project, and then the jobs will expand to over 100. I can't remember the exact number. I want to say around 140 jobs.
Go ahead.
So right now it's $11 million. If they get this grant, it would go from $11 million to $250 million investment there in Chester County.
That's
and
correct.
Double the amount of jobs as well.
That's correct.
And these lithium ion batteries, these are the ones that are from electric vehicles, consumer electronics, for example, energy storage batteries. Hence why you were talking about catching fire. We've heard of cases like on an airplane, right, where a lithium battery device has caught fire or somewhere in someone's house. So that's good.
And you don't just put water on them. It sometimes makes it worse.
Worse. I was about to say, that sounds like it would make it worse. Now, where in Chester County is this facility going to be located?
So it's, I'll tell you.
And you can't just say the country.
Yeah, well, remember that if you try to tell me how to get somewhere in Chester, I have to use GPS
because
so many curvy country roads still.
He's fairly new.
He's also a little belt road.
Okay.
And so it's what I call, when I talk about Chester, it's closer into the bypass.
Okay.
It's not very far out of Chester. You've got your Richburg. Mm-hmm. You know, when you're on Highway 9, you're going to Richburg, and then you have Fort Lawn. This is all the way into what I consider Chester. It's Chester Fire Department's jurisdiction.
Okay.
But it's off of Belt Road. It's in the old Shea Nano building, which the building actually suited them very well for the process. So if they do expand, if they get that Department of Energy grant and they do expand, they're going to build another facility also on that same property.
That's great.
It's big enough for their expansion.
Great.
Has all the power they need. Obviously, the gas, unlimited natural gas, and the water and sewer supply. So we're very good in that position.
And do you know how many companies? I know it's called again Princeton New Energy, and yes, Princeton. It was founded out of Princeton University in 2019. How many companies are like the one that's coming to Chester County? I know you said there's one in Texas, but is there other ones, or this is pretty much going to be the two right now?
There are no other ones.
Really?
This is, and in fact, the one they're out of New Jersey is kind of home base, and they had a partnership with another company, and I can't think of the name of the other company up there. And that company allowed them to use a portion of their building. And then in Texas, that's where they set their pilot plant up. Was it's in another company, has an operation, and they gave them a portion of this manufacturing facility in McKinney, Texas. And we flew out. We left at 5:30 in the morning. Our plane was delayed out of Charlotte. We landed at 11 a.m., drove an hour from the airport to McKinney, went in their facility, had lunch. They gave us another presentation, took a tour, asked a bunch of questions, drove back to the airport, got on a plane at 7 o'clock, flew back home to Charlotte, got in about 11 that night. So
All
in a day's work here in
well, there you go.
It paid off, right?
That's right.
You got
sure
an $11 million investment in Chester County and 41 jobs. You sounded like a flight attendant. You probably should have just worked on the plane, to be honest with you, Brian. That would have been
I'm not big on flying, so I'm just telling you.
It's not for the faint of heart, for sure.
Speaking of money, Chester County did pass its $34 million budget, which includes new jobs such as a county planner and several fire and EMS positions. There is not a tax increase this year. Chester County employees did get a 4% raise, and there is a maternity leave policy that the county will pay for the first 6 weeks. The county there in Chester also worked out an agreement with an urgent care center where employees and their dependents can go there at no charge and receive care.
Hey, hon, can you grab the door? We are getting quotes for replacing the roof today.
Well, hey there. I'm here to talk about your roof.
Low price? Forget about it.
Don't open your home to just any roofing contractor. When it comes to your home, knowledge and skill matters.
Hi, I'm Hayden with Brown's Roofing. We're here to help.
With over 30 years of experience, Brown's Roofing is the area's expert on all aspects of roofing. To have it done right, call the roofing professionals at Brown's Roofing today.
Hey, can I use your bathroom?
What's the best way to attract a wide variety of beautiful birds to your backyard? By offering the birds the right foods in expertly designed bird feeders from Wild Birds Unlimited. Whether you've been feeding the birds for a while or are just getting started, let our backyard bird feeding specialists show you how to add a little joy to your life and make nature a part of every day. Shop now for exclusive bird foods, feeders, hardware, and more. Wild Birds Unlimited, products designed by experts. Trusted local advice.
Coke Zero is now Coke Zero Sugar, with great Coke taste. Some people were excited to hear the news, some were skeptical. So we're not going to have the star of the show you're watching come out and say, "You'll love it." No special jingle written by this week's hottest pop star. No famous internet celebs who happen to be holding the label just so. Okay, maybe just one little pour shot. The only thing that will make you believe Coke Zero Sugar has great Coke taste is trying it yourself. Ice cold Coke Zero Sugar. Try one today.
Coming to Charlotte, North Carolina, a great Father's Day gift for the special man in your life. Remembering Luther Vandross, featuring the amazing voice of Cedric Bowler and Real Good Sax Vibes by Adrian Crutchfield, the last saxophonist to tour and record with Prince, June 22nd, 2024, Knights Theater, 8 p.m. Tickets on sale at blumenthalarts.org/events, performed just as Luther would.
Welcome back to CN2 Now. They are world changers, young people on mission trips, providing hands-on mission experiences, which is helping churches and developing students and their walk in faith. They are in York County this week. Here are a few of the world changers' representatives, Jack Blankenship and Livy Holbrook.
It's a nonprofit, and youth from all over the country come into a different Project City every week. Or a set comes into a Project City. And we pretty much train them on how to share the gospel on Monday. Typically on a regular 5-day, we send them out to different work sites. And they're split into crews, so they're not all from the same church. They're from all different churches. And they work on painting. They can do porches. They do disabled wheelchair ramps. And they do all this physical labor, but really the focus is to share the gospel with the homeowner or the neighbors or just the whole community, and really be the hands and feet of Jesus through the whole entire community.
So Jack, you're boots on the ground here. So mm-hmm. when you're not involved with World Changers, you're over there at the BCM, right? Mm-hmm. For Winthrop University.
Yes.
So walk us through what this week has looked like here in York County.
Yeah, it's pretty great. My wife and I met doing World Changers a long time ago, 24 years ago. And I started World Changers as a high school student in 1993. So I've got a long tradition. And World Changers has been in Rock Hill for a long time. In fact, there was a 20-year span where over 5,000 participants had come. And then there was a 5-year span where it wasn't. And this is the second year being back. And it's pretty great because we partner with the city. And so the city helps identify the houses, provides the funding for the materials, and then our students come in and our volunteers come in and provide the labor. And so those costs are not there. And so it's a great way for us to tangibly show people that we care about them, that we love them, and just Jesus has changed us, so we want to be that for other people. And it's made an impact. One study had shown in that 20 years that Rock Hill was here, I believe the number was like $2.3 million in labor cost had been donated. And but it's like Livy said, it's our faith kept within ourselves is not, you know, Jesus told us to love people and serve people. And that's what we want to be. We want to be that. And so we've been working with the city. Our construction coordinator and has been working with, and the city's fantastic. Rock Hill Schools, we're staying over at the old Finley Road Elementary School, and they have been top-notch helping us out there. We got a team that came in from Texas that's volunteering and cooking all of our food, and it's been a great week.
Well, we know church is not necessarily in a building, right? Mm-hmm. Church is outside the yeah. walls of a building, yeah. and we hear that a lot in our faith-based communities. It's nice to gather once mm-hmm. or twice a week or sometimes more, but church is serving those yeah. out in the community.
I was able to participate. Jack and I were just talking. So I was a world changer all through my high school years. And so people often say, have you ever been on a mission trip? And to me, when I think, so even as an adult, like, well, I've never been out of the country on a mission trip. But then I kind of step back and think, you know, I have been on a mission trip. Yeah. And so I did participate with World Changers from 1994 to 1999. And I didn't know how to roof. I mean, I was up on a roof. Like, you know, I didn't know how to roof. And here you are as a teenager, and, you know, you think you've got all these problems. And really, that was the first time I was taken out of the blessings that I had to see how other people sometimes lived. And so it totally did change me as a 16-year-old girl. But to see the way that when we met that homeowner, Miss Rosa especially, on that Sunday afternoon, and then how she had changed by Friday when we left. I mean, it was like a transformation. You saw, you know, and I remember her saying, you know, she didn't have family and people didn't really come anymore. Wow. And so people were rallying around her, and how she got out there and brought us lemonade. Mm-hmm. The poor lady didn't hardly have anything, but she was providing us peanut butter sandwiches that she would cut in squares, and lemonade, and coming out, and the neighborhood kids. It was just, it truly was life-changing. And while y'all are changing the world for these people in these communities, you're also changing those teenagers.
Yeah, very much so. Very much so.
Jack, to Ashley's point a little bit, if she didn't know much about roofing, so with some of these projects, if they're doing some roofing or some, you know, bigger projects, there are folks that go behind them and
yes.
make sure everything's
yeah.
legit. And
yeah.
They're
well,
just helping to supply the labor and to understand.
Right. And okay. so each one, we call them crews when okay. we divide our students up. Mm-hmm. And they're with one or two people from their church and then people they don't know. Each crew has what we call a crew chief, who is someone who's experienced in construction. And some of them are, they do it for a living. Some of them, if they just know how to do it. And then we have a construction coordinator and some supervisors. And so they work really tightly. And our construction coordinator, he is in construction, so he knows he's able to help out. And some of them are as simple as painting. And some of them, we have ripped total porches off and had to redo foundation stuff. And it's mm-hmm. been pretty intense. And it's great because, you know, it's like Ashley said, students say they don't know how to do these things, but they get the opportunity to mm-hmm. do it. And I will say this, some people think that this is a boy thing.
No.
But the girls outwork the boys at almost every project, and they get up, they swing hammers and pick up heavy stuff, and it's pretty great to see that.
So. Yeah.
Livy Holbrook is with World Changers. Jack Blankenship is with World Changers as well. He's a project coordinator, but Jack is right here, boots on the ground, and Livy is with the organization and travels throughout the country during the summer months. How many homes were you able to accomplish or get taken care of this week?
So this week we did 10 in the city of Rock Hill, and we helped over at the Catawba Nation. I know we've done at least 12, like, painting and staining decks over there, and we won't know the total number because they're rocking and trying to get more finished today. So hopefully around 20 or so.
That's
time
amazing.
We get it done over there.
And it took place just this week?
Just this week. Okay. They came in on Monday, so they've only been working since Tuesday, and they will finish today. And it doesn't look like any project is going to be unfinished. Looks like we're going to be able to button up everything this afternoon, and then they leave out of here early in the morning to go back home. So,
well, we have our dates for the next summer at world-changers.net, and the rates are on there, explanation of what we're about and what you're going to be doing mm-hmm. and all that. And also, we don't just have 5 days. We have 5, 6 days, 7 days. So lots of different options.
Perfect.
Carolina Connection is brought to you by Wild Birds Unlimited. For more information, visit rockhill.wbu.com or indianland.wbu.com. Wild Birds Unlimited. We bring people and nature together.
Stay with CN2 Now. We are back right after this.
When you're getting a bundle from Comporia, you're getting an all-seeing, all-knowing personal security detail. You're getting shows and shows and, oh yeah, more shows. You're getting a social calendar filled with family game time, game day get-togethers, and don't worry, we saved you a spot on the couch parties because we're not just your internet company. We're your yes to all of the above company.
Since 1939 and through more than 80 years of windstorms, hailstorms, thunderstorms, tornadoes, and even a few hurricanes, H&S Roofing and Gutter Company has been there 24/7, setting Charlotte's standard for quality and service. With H&S, you have an experienced ally helping you navigate the insurance claim process, along with the skilled craftsman to handle any job, from a small repair to a complete roof replacement. Storm damage? Call the experts who've been doing it since 1939. H&S Roofing and Gutter Company.
When a catastrophe hits, it can be a very stressful time for you. When you have trees on your house, when you have trees on your cars, and you don't know what to do, you call us.
We're not a 1-800 number, we're an 803 number. We've been in business for over 60 years because we take care of our clients. That means taking care of them during claim situations.
We're not 9-to-5, we're 24/7. We're gonna be there when you need us most. Gill Insurance, your local auto owner's agent. Understanding business is how we do business.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
If you need assistance with your utility expenses, call your local Community Actions County office. The Low Income Home Emergency Assistance Program, LIHEAP, is designed to help low-income households meet their emergency home, heating, and cooling needs. LIHEAP places emphasis on serving those households whose utilities have been disconnected or at risk of disconnection. If you need assistance with your utility expenses to heat or cool your home, call your local Community Actions County office or visit us online at carolinacommunityactions.org.
You're watching CN2 Now. Here is our latest CN2 Now picture of the day, brought to you by Champion Services. The Worthy Boys and Girls Camp is underway in Rock Hill. It's put on by the Rock Hill Police Department. The camp offers boys and girls the chance to experience the joys of camping, such as water slides and kayaking on the lake. This is the 75th year of operation for that camp. Thanks for watching CN2 Now. We will see you bright and early for Palmetto Mornings Monday starting at 6 a.m. here on CN2 and on the radio on FM 100.1 on
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? Yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
Hi, I'm John Warden with Champion Services. If you're considering remodeling or making repairs to your home due to storm damage, here's a few things to ponder. A lot of folks have come in town promising a lot of things about we are here, we've been here for a long period of time, only to be found false. Choosing the right contractor is extremely important. Here at Champion Services, our goal is one thing, it's customer satisfaction. And that's just not a sentence, that's a fact. Let me say it's been a joy to serve you for over 30 years. This message is brought to you by Champion Services.
When it comes to prescription medications and health needs, Rock Hill residents have been turning to Good Pharmacy for over 50 years.
I've been coming to Good Pharmacy since we came to Rock Hill in 1984, and I would not change pharmacists for anything.
With their knowledgeable staff, you can always trust that your prescription will be filled with complete confidence and care for your health. Good Pharmacy, conveniently located at the corner of Ebenezer Road and Camden Avenue.
From my first watch I purchased as a teenager, which still runs today, to the diamond ring I surprised my wife with, which she still talks about today, a gift from Norman Hagee is as good as it gets. Whether it's elegant timepieces by Bulova, Caravelle, and Bel Air, or ornamental ironwork-inspired Southern Gates collection, or dazzling fine jewelry, a gift from Hagee is backed by over 60 years of family-owned and operated experience. Norman Hagee Jewelers,